Hi students, welcome to Sunil Engineering Academy. I am Sunil Kumar Bandaru, plus educator in an academy. Students, I have already completed one class on this general science physics topic electricity. Students, I already said these classes are not only useful for your only RRB examinations. These are useful for your NTPC, Group D, SSC, CGL, CHSL, MTS, or your state group 1, group 2, group 3 or such volume jobs. Okay. So wherever the general science, these classes are useful. Okay. So we have completed already one session. In that session, what we have learned, just I want to revise within 1 minute. So electricity, in that, first of all, we have learned what is a charge and the units and current definition and the units of the current. Okay, and how to measure the current and resistance formula and resistivity and the terms conductance and conductivity. Okay, and conductance and conductivity. Yeah, now I'm going to start today class. So we have learned resistance, and resistance only depend upon length and area only. R is equal to rho L by A. So it depends upon rho and L and A, and this resistance also depend upon temperature. Also depends on temperature. Very, very important point. Depends on temperature. We know very well, we can divide the materials into three types. One is nothing but conductors, which allows the current through them, are nothing but conductors. Okay. And also we can say semiconductors, semiconductors, and also insulators. Insulators are those which may not allow the electricity, which may not allow the electricity. Conductors are nothing but we can consider simply metals, that means copper, silver, aluminium, all these are nothing but we can say conductors. And semiconductors, the devices with the silicon and germanium. And insulators are nothing but we can consider wood, rock, plastic, and all these are nothing but we can consider as the insulator. They may not allow the electricity. Okay. So these are allows the partially, and conductors allows the electricity through them. Okay. Here, how the resistance is depend upon temperature? It is depend upon temperature in case of conductors. In case of conductors, as the temperature increases, the resistance also increases. In case of the semiconductors, as temperature increases, the resistance will going to decreases. Why? Because here the temperature coefficient of resistance, of resistance, that is denoted by the alpha. This alpha is equal to RT minus R naught, by R naught into T, Okay. Here for conductors, this alpha value is positive, That means here, if alpha value is the positive, if you want, the resistance, at a T degree centigrade is equal to, come on friends, try to solve this one. At resistance at T degree centigrade is equal to alpha into R naught T plus R naught, R naught plus alpha into R naught T. That means if you common R naught, that is 1 plus alpha T. That means here from this equation we can get understand that as T increases, this total part is going to increases, then resistance at T degree centigrade is increases. Okay, so for conductors alpha is positive. Due to that, as temperature increases, resistance is going to increases. Okay, and here, the semiconductors and these insulators, this alpha is negative. negative. So if you place in the plus, means here you have place negative minus, then as temperature increases, this total part is going to decreases. So this resistance is going to decreases. Okay, this resistance is going to decrease. As alpha is negative, then RT is equal to R naught into 1 minus alpha T. If as T increases, this resistance is going to be decreases. Okay, so very, very important question. Very, very important question. In case of conductors, as temperature increases, what happened to the resistance? Increases, decreases, remains constant, none. So as temperature increases, resistance also going to be increases. Okay, resistance also going to be increases. And sometimes we are also getting the question on resistivity rho. Resistivity rho, that is nothing but here in this resistivity, which is least resistivity element, which is least resistivity element or specific resistance element, resistivity element, very, very important one, which is least resistivity element, that is nothing but silver. Silver is considered as least resistivity element. Okay, so that's why for a given length, for a given area, it has the least resistivity, means the resistance also least. So that's why you can consider which is the best conductor of electricity, silver. So we can consider silver is the best conductor of electricity. Also consider as best conductor of electricity. That is also very, very important one. Silver is considered as best conductor of electricity. Okay. And now coming to the next one. What I said, after resistance, we will discuss another term, that is nothing but voltage. So very, very important one, voltage. You can also consider as potential. You can also consider as potential, electric potential or potential difference. Okay, denoted by the letter V. Okay, here what is this voltage? Voltage we can consider it is just as the energy. Energy to move the electrons. Energy required to move the electrons. Here we have already discussed that current is nothing but flow of electrons. How the current flow? If that current want to flow, there must be a voltage or electric potential or potential difference. Whenever there is a potential difference, then only the current will flow. All of you listen carefully. If you consider here, it is a one pipe. Okay. Here without any pressure difference, at this input and this output, there is no water will flow. Okay. If you have not applied any external force here, the water may not flow very fastly in this horizontal pipe. That means whenever there is no pressure difference at this place 1 and place 2, there is no current will flow. But whenever you have created a pressure difference by connecting that pipe like this, then here a different pressure, here a different pressure. So here let's consider high pressure, here low pressure. So water always flows from this due to this pressure differences. The water will flow. Like that, here also, whenever there is a voltage difference, whenever there is a potential difference, then only that current will flow. Okay. Here, there is no pressure difference, means we are creating the pressure like this. Here there is no voltage difference, means how to create that voltage difference or potential difference? By giving the voltage. By any AC supply or by using the battery. By using the AC supply, we can create that potential difference. whenever we are creating that potential difference, then the current will be flow. That means here we can also denote that the voltage symbol is like this na. One is a positive, one is a negative. Or we can also consider it is in AC case, we can denote like this. Okay, here phase and neutral. Here positive means it has, if it is denoted as 10 volt means positive is 10 volt and negative is 0. So 10 to 0, there is a voltage difference is created. Voltage difference is created. Here also phase, for example, 230 volts they have given. Phase has a 230 volt. Okay, negative, that is neutral has 0 volt. So there is a potential difference is created or not. 230 to 0. So the current will flow from that 230 to 0. Current will flow from that 230 to 0. Okay, like that it will be flow. Okay. So voltage is nothing but, or potential difference is nothing but energy required to flow the current. Energy required to flow the current. It is general understanding. General understanding, I am giving this definition. Okay. In actual case, we can consider the voltage is nothing but work done on unit positive charge. Work done on unit positive charge. That is a very, very important one. Work done on unit positive charge. Unit positive charge. So this is the W is nothing but work done and Q is nothing but charge. So whenever the current want to flow, whenever the current want to flow from this one to this one, here some work will be done. This voltage will do some work. Due to that work, the current will be flow or the charge will be flow. Okay. So work done on unit positive charge is nothing but volt. Okay. Or voltage. Here, what are the units of this volt? Units of this volt. Here, units of this voltage. Voltage units are nothing but volt na? Volt. Here, work units are nothing but joules. And charge units are nothing but coulombs. Now, all of you, let me know. All of you understand that here 1 volt is equal to dash. 1 volt is equal to dash. 1 joule per 1 coulomb na? 1 joule per 1 coulomb. Very, very important one. 1 joule per 1 coulomb. So we have to understand that 1 volt is equal to 1 joule per coulomb as per the equation of W by Q. Okay, it is a very, very important relation. Why? Because sometimes they will give voltage value. Sometimes they will give charge value. They are asking about work done. Okay. So we can easily calculate. Work done is equal to V into Q. Okay. Now this voltage is measured by which device? This voltage is measured by which device? As the name itself, as the unit name itself, it has the meter. Voltage units are volts. And measured by device voltmeter. Measured by voltmeter. Okay, we have already discussed about the ammeter. Ammeter is always connected in series. I have given now. Now, if you want, if you take one bulb. Okay, if you want to measure the voltage across the bulb is nothing but we have to connect the voltmeter across that bulb. Then only it can measure the potential difference or voltage. Potential difference or voltage between the two points. Okay. So we have to connect the voltmeter always parallel. Connect voltmeter in parallel to circuit. In parallel to circuit to measure that one. Okay. So and another important one. In the ammeter, what we have learned, internal resistance is nothing but zero. Here, voltmeter, what about the internal resistance? Internal resistance is nothing but infinity in case of this voltmeter. These are the differences in case of voltmeter and ammeter. In case of this voltmeter and ammeter, okay? And also, always try to remember that current flow whenever there is voltage difference, and another point, current always flow in a closed circuit. Whenever the circuit is open, that means whenever there is a open circuit. In case of open circuit, current is zero. What is meant by open circuit? For example, here there is some voltage is there, and there is some resistance is there. Okay, but this circuit is not closed. It is open. In case of this open, the current will flow is zero. Whatever the voltage, the current is zero. Okay, and what is meant by short circuit? Short circuit means if a wire is connected between these two points, then you can consider it is a short circuit or closed circuit. Closed circuit. Whenever it is a closed one, then you can get the current. Okay, you can get the current. And now after this voltage, so we have learned what is a voltage, what is a current, and what is a resistance. Now relation between all those. Relation between voltage, current, and resistance. What is the relation between voltage, current, and resistance? It is given by a law, very very important one law. It is given by Ohm's law. That means what is this Ohm's law? This Ohm's law is nothing but at constant temperature, the voltage or the potential difference between any two points is directly proportional to current flowing through that conductor. The potential difference in any two points is directly proportional to the current flowing through that conductor. Okay, that means here as the voltage difference increases or voltage increases, the current also increases. Okay, so V proportional to I. If you remove the proportionality constant, we require one constant. That constant is nothing but resistance. So we can say V is equal to IR. This is a very, 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 very important, friends. Why? Because in most of the problems, they have given any two terms and we want to find the remaining terms. Okay, that's why it is a very, very important. We can also understand this one by using a triangle, by using a voltage triangle. Here it is a voltage, here it is a current, it is a resistance. Okay, so V is equal to I into R. Okay, and if you want I is equal to V by R. If you want R is equal to V by I. So we can represent like this also. Okay, so if you know this equation, you can find resistance, you can find current, you can find voltage if they have given any other two terms. So if you consider this voltage proportional to current, then what about the curve, friends? Here what I have given, each and every point is important. Don't feel that one point is important, one point is not important. Don't feel like that. Okay, so if you are preparing for any exams, for example any groups exam, group 1, group 2 or group 3 exams, these are useful for your state exams also. Okay, if you consider it is a current, here directly proportional means as the voltage increases, the current also increases now. So what about the curve here? So Ohm's law represent which curve? Linear curve. All of you getting my point? It is also very important. This Ohm's law, will gives the curve is nothing but between voltage and current. That curve is nothing but linear curve. That curve is nothing but you can say linear curve. Okay, linear curve. And the very very important point is nothing but this Ohm's law is applicable to. That means this V proportional to I. The Ohm's law. That is V proportional to I. This is applicable to only conductor, friends. Applicable to only conductors. That means it may not applicable to. It is very very important. It may not applicable to. It may not applicable to semiconductors. Semiconductors. That means silicon, comma germanium devices. Devices. That is, let us consider diode, transistors. Transistors. Okay. And the second one, it is not applicable to insulators. Not applicable to insulators. We know very well rock, wood, plastic, and all those. And the next one, it may not applicable to vacuum tubes. Vacuum tubes. And it may not applicable to electrolytes. Electrolytes. For example, H2SO4. Okay. So it may not applicable to means as the voltage increases, current may not increases proportionally. Current may not increases proportionally. It may not use the straight line passing through the horizon. Straight line passing through the horizon. Okay. So it may not applicable to all this. Very, very important one. Okay. So here we are getting the linear curve. The curve representing by the Ohm's law. Nothing but linear curve. Very very important. Linear parabola or square, they will give like that. Okay, so it is a linear curve. And coming to the next one. So we have discussed about all those important points. That is nothing but voltage, resistance, and current. Voltage, resistance, and current. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the another two terms, that is inductance and capacitance. Inductance. Very very important one. Inductance is denoted by the letter L, and the what are the units? Units are Henry. Units are Henry. Okay. Units are also very very important, friends. Units are also Henry. That means inductance. How the inductance form means. Whenever if you consider any one core, if you wound the wire, if you twisted the wire in that core, then there is a inductance will be formed. Inductance will be formed. That inductance is nothing but L is equal to mu n square A by L. Mu n square A by L. Here L is nothing but length. Okay. So that is nothing but you can consider here what is this mu? Mu is the permeability. Mu is the permeability. That is ability of it permits the magnetic flux. Ability of the permit it how much of flux it will be permits. Okay, that is nothing but permeability. N is number of turns. Number of turns. N is number of turns. A is area of cross section. L is length. L is length. Okay. So that means L is mu n square A by L. That means this L value is directly proportional to n square. That means if the number of turns are increases, then inductance will be also increases. Okay. So that is a very very important one. So inductance is L, and it is nothing but mu n square A by L. That is, it is directly proportional to n square. Okay. Yeah. Here we have already discussed that this inductance and capacitance are nothing but storage elements.
storage elements. And what is the purpose of this inductance? What it will do? Inductor stores energy in electromagnetic form. Very, very important question. Inductor stores energy in which form? It is a electromagnetic form. And what about that magnitude of the energy? That magnitude of energy EL is equal to half EL I square. It is a current phenomena. Okay. EL is equal to half LI square. If you consider any one inductor, this is the symbol of the inductor. Okay. Symbol of the inductor. Here the voltage across the inductor VL is equal to, and that value of inductance L into di by dt. That means from this equation we can understand that this inductor very, very important point, all of you note this: inductor opposes the sudden changes in current. That means it may not allow the changes in this current di by dt. Here, how to understand that one means, all of you listen carefully, then one you can understand. Here, in case of VL is equal to L into di by dt. Sudden change means within very less time. So, I want to take that sudden change is nothing but zero. Sudden time is nothing but zero. If it is a zero, then there is nothing but, then what you are getting, friends? What you are getting? Anything by zero is nothing but infinity now. So, here VL is equal to infinity. But there is no infinity voltage is exist. Infinity voltage may not exist. Okay. So, infinity voltage may not exist means, but it is really not happening. It is not happened means, here how many elements here we have? Only one element we have. The inductor. That means this inductor always trying to not happen that much of high voltage. It is doing that. It is not make the voltage as infinity. It may not allowing the sudden changes in current. Only one element is there. That is the inductor. That only can do some work now. It is not allowing the sudden changes in current. That's why only the voltage is not infinite. So that is nothing but here we can understand that this inductor may not allow the sudden changes in current. In the same way, capacitor also may not allow the sudden changes in voltage. That is a voltage phenomena. Okay. So these are the important points in case of inductor. Okay. Inductor opposes the sudden changes in current. Okay. And inductance units are Henry, we have learned, and the energy stored in inductor, that is nothing but half Li square, and the equation also we have learned, voltage across this is equal to L into di by dt. Okay. And any important points on this inductor? If any important points, we will discuss in the MCQs. And coming to the next one, capacitor. Very, very important one. After this capacitor, we will discuss series and parallel connection of elements in detail. Okay. Here capacitor is denoted by the letter C, and the units are farads. Units are very, very important, friends. Okay. And here the symbol of this capacitor is nothing but like this. You can denote like this. Or you can also denote like this. Okay, that means here these two lines are belongs to two parallel plates. That means here you can understand that whenever it is a one charged plate, it is another charged plate. Whenever we are separating the charged plate 1 and charged plate 2 with a some dielectric, with some dielectric, the dielectric may be dielectric. What is meant by dielectric? Dielectric is nothing but which may not allow the electricity. Okay, so that is nothing but you can consider air or mica or paper. These are nothing but you can consider as dielectric. Okay, so whenever we are placing those dielectric with a distance of d, with a distance of d, and the plate area is a, and the plate area is a, then capacitance is equal to epsilon a by d. Very, very important one, all of you note down. C is equal to epsilon a by d. Okay, so that means you can understand that capacitance is directly proportional to area, and capacitance is inversely proportional to distance. Inversely proportional to distance. Let us understand this one. Here, whenever the distance between the two plates, d is the distance between the two plates, is very less, then what about the capacitance? Is very high. Capacitance is very high. In the same way, whenever the distance between the two plates is very high, the distance between the two plates is very high, then capacitance will be low. Why? Because inversely proportional. So this capacitance depends on epsilon, area, and distance between the plates. Okay, distance between the plates. Here I want to give that one. Capacitance depends on first one, nature of dielectric, that is epsilon, and the second one, distance between plates, and the third one, area of the plates. But the very, very important point, capacitance may not depend on thickness of plates. It may not depend upon this thickness of plates. It may not depend upon thickness of the plates. That is a very, very important one. Okay, now we have another relation on this capacitance, charge, and V. Relation between Q C V. Here charge is equal to product of this capacitance and voltage. It is also a very, very important relation. And we have already discussed that this inductor and capacitors are storage elements. Now, these storage elements, if these are storage elements, the capacitor stores energy in which form? Capacitor stores energy in electrostatic form. That means charge form. Electrostatic form, that is nothing but we can consider charge form. Okay, it is nothing but charge form. In this charge form, it will be stores. And that charge, that energy stored in capacitor EC is equal to half CV square. Okay, and we have also already learned in case of one equation, in case of inductor, here also we can consider here current flowing through this capacitor IC is equal to C dB by dt. Here also, within less time, it may not allow the sudden changes in voltage. So we can consider capacitor opposes the sudden changes in voltage. Opposes
The sudden changes in voltage.
Sudden changes in voltage. Okay, these are the very very important points in case of capacitor. Okay, in case of capacitor. Here sometimes they will give energy stored in capacitor different formats. If you want different values, you can get in place of CV, you can apply Q. Then off you will get in the place of CV, if you substitute this Q, off Q into V you will get. Okay. So like that you can change your equation. You can change your equation. Okay. So this is about the capacitance. This is about the capacitance. Now I want to finalize. I want to finalize all this one very very important formulas. I is equal to Q by T we have learned. Okay. And also resistance R is equal to rho L by A we have learned. And also we have learned that is voltage is equal to W by Q. And we have learned the relation between voltage and current and resistance. V is equal to I into R. And also we have learned L is equal to mu n square A by L. And also we have learned C is equal to epsilon A by D. Okay. And also charge Q is equal to CV. Okay. So these are the formulas we have learned. And every formula is very very important. Okay. We don't want to miss at least one mark. Okay. So these are the very very important formulas we have learned in this class. In the next class we will learn that is nothing but a series connection of elements and parallel connection of elements. And if resistors are connected in series, what will happen? Resistors are connected in parallel, what will happen? We will discuss each and every one in the next class. Okay. So students, don't feel that these are the lengthy classes. These are not lengthy classes. Each and every point is important. Each and every point is important. We want score. That is the important one. Okay. And one more thing, if you listen just one time, it seems to be very very easy. Okay. If you listen, concentrate. Okay. Then all topics are very very easy. If all topics are, you have understand that, no need to by hand, no need to remember. You can just revise whenever there is a before the exam, then you can get. Okay. Okay. Thank you, students. And one more thing, students, if you want PDF notes of my classes, then you can get from www.sunilengineeringacademy.com. sunilengineeringacademy.com. You will get the link in my description box also. You can get the link in my description box also. Okay. You can download physics, chemistry, biology, whatever it may be, you can get. Okay. And also try to subscribe this channel and please share the information to all your friends. Okay. Then I can continue more sessions. Okay. Thank you so much, students. I want to end the session. Thank you so much.